Hello, you are watching a demonstration video from my new created activation module. Here is a diagram of the user experience of the activation control. A user buys a program using his PayPal email address. PayPal's servers will tell my server the user bought a program. My server will write the user's email into the database. After the user has bought the program, he can download and execute the program. He will see a dialog to enter his email address. All he has to do now is press the activate button, and the program will work. I'll show you a demonstration now. This user just bought the program, and it is not activated yet. When he opens the program, he will see this window. If he tries to activate the program with an email address that's not in our database, he will see this dialog that notifies him, and ask if he wants to request a new activation. This is for users that already bought the program, but activated too many times, or for people that downloaded the program without paying. If the user enters a wrong email address, the program would automatically close itself. But, in this case the user is a legitimate user, and did pay for the program, so he can activate using his email. As you can see, the program is now activated. If the user closes the program, and reopens it, it will still be activated. If you are a developer, you might think that the activation control is hard to use. Well, it's not. Anyone without any knowledge about programming could use my activation control. I'll show you how. This is a new project to demonstrate how easy it is. First I'll run it without the activation control. See, it runs as expected. Now I'll demonstrate how to add activation. You just add the activation control as a new file, and it will appear in your toolbox. Now just create a new instance on your main form, like so. The place of the control does not matter, it will resize itself to the proper place and size. After that, double-click your form, and add one line of code, to tell the activation control what the main form is. Now if I run the program, you can see you'll have to activate first.